Welcome, guys. So this video will basically talk about random walks. And there are so many random walks problems, like classical random walks, quantum random walks, however you want. Or Brownian motion or something which is very can be very difficult, or stochastic calculus, or some of them are basically just related to a random walk. But nowadays, today we want to talk about the easiest question. Basically you just have the random walk in two dimension. By the way, the random walk in one dimension is very easy, that you can solve it by yourself. Also 50-50 chance of moving one step east, one step west, or the one step north or south. The moving is repeated from the new position, and so it's indefinite, so you will keep doing. So what is the chance that the particle returns to origin? Or is the chance that particle returns to the origin? Okay, and I want to ask a similar problems as 3D. Or basically I want to ask a similar problem for general D dimension. Okay, so this is the problem what I want to solve. Okay. So you can try it yourself, and after you think it's okay, then we can start. Okay, so we just solve 2D. So solving 2D, which is after n steps. After 2n steps. Why 2n, not n, right? Because if you want to go back to origin, at least you need the number of steps must be even, because you need to go right and go left, or you go north or go south. So at least you need to 2n steps to go back to origin. Okay, so the probability that 2n steps at origin basically is that so your x position is 0, your y position is 0, and what we need to, what is the x position to be 0? Okay, so suppose I give you the 2n steps, then you can go right or go left, so basically if I only count the 2n to be right, or if I only count the 2n steps, I only count all the steps from left or right. Okay, then the answer just 2n, we choose n. And we for each why we choose n? Because in 2n step I need to choose n to go east and n to go west. And for each one the probability is 1 over 2n. Right? Oh sorry, 1 over have 2n, because we have 2n steps. Okay, so this answer is just this number square. Okay. Okay, so the key point is that what we need to compute is this at large n. Basically, if you follow my previous video, or I have a previous video talk about Stirling formula. Basically, n factorial just square root of 2 pi n times n divided by n e to the n. Okay, so we can use this. And basically, it's 2n factorial, n factorial, n factorial, 2 to 2n. Okay, and once you use this formula, okay. The computation is somewhat complicated. I'm afraid of I will do something wrong, but okay, I try my best to prove to get the correct answers. So basically you have e to the 2n, and e to the 2n will cancel with so this e to the n will cancel for from the numerator and denominator. So this one is just this. The e is cancel 2 to 2n, so we can get the answer should be the n to n, this n to n to n to n will cancel, and 2 to 2n will cancel with this. So the answer is square root of pi n, which is close to, I should say approximately 1 over square root of pi n. Okay, so from this, what we can get is the origin. The probability at the origin after 2n step is close to pi n. Okay, so the key is we just sum of this, right? We want to sum of this from n to infinity. Okay, and this is diverge, right? Everybody knows about this. Is basically if you sum large n, basically this is log n, and then the proof is just you sum of this 1 over x, and this approximately for area is approximately by 1 over n, 1 to n, 1 over x dx. Okay, so it's pi log n. So which tell you that as n goes to infinity, this integral, right, blows up. Okay, blows up. Okay, so this, but we know that probability must be bounded, Okay, so this tell you that the random, I should say the particle or the man, okay, returns to zero infinitely often. So the probabilities for a particle returns zero is 1, and then not just 1, it returns infinitely often. Okay, so I should say that nearly every particle returns infinitely often, because I mean you can say that if someone keep going the right or the keep going northeast, and this is possible, but this kind of path is measure zero. I should say that in measure theory language is basically measure zero. Okay, so the answer is for 2D, then you will return to the zero infinitely often. Okay, so now we solve the 3D. Okay, so 3D case is very, is exactly the same, right? It basically just x, y, z, and so basically 1 over pi squared root of pi n to the cube, So the answer is pi 1.5 times n to the 1.5 power. Okay, so we just sum of this. Okay, so this is the P series. So let me remind you guys that the P series 1 over n to the p converge if p less than 1, diverge if p less than 1, converge if p larger than 1. Okay, so this will converge, and then you can use the numerical to calculate this answer. Okay, so this answer is 0.315. Okay, so basically in 2-3 dimension, that so this is not a probability, right? This is the probability that the sum of the that this is the mean, okay. Okay, so basically, what tell you that is that in this case, the probability go back to origin is finite. Okay, it's finite. Okay, so this is finite. Okay, and we can compute this by a following formula. This formula can be proved, but I will not prove here. Basically, if I denote this Q to be the this P x to n to this 2n then I sum of this probability, and I can compute this. I should add one, and I can compute the okay, so I should let this to be 1, and I can compute this 1 over q and minus 1. And then this is the, oh sorry, you should compute this 1 minus 1 over q. This is the true probabilities. So at the beginning, we have a probability 0.315, and then we plug in this, and we get 1.315, and then we plug in, we can get a true, basically 0.761. Of the probability that go back to origin. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay, and okay, I think it's okay, and for general D, you just do a similar, just check, change this 1 over square root pi into the D, then you can use this formula to compute this q equals this, and p true equals to 1 over 1 minus q. Basically, I can okay, so I can explain why this is true. Okay, and I think it's difficult to just easily saying this. Okay, but I will, okay, so maybe I will do another video to talk about why this formula is true, but I think it's enough for today, and be sure to subscribe to my channel. Thanks.